Hello, space fans, and welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. In this episode, astronomers at the European Southern Observatory have observed an exoplanet that is tidally locked around its star. And because of this, it has extreme temperatures on the daytime and the nighttime side. The temperatures are so hot that on the day side, iron is a gas, and at night, that gas condenses into molten iron rain. It seems the more that we look for and at exoplanets, the stranger some of them become. We tend to be really focused on the Earth-like ones because, well, we like to fantasize that somehow, someday, we could maybe possibly live on one of those. But Earth-like planets are elusive compared to all the others that are out there, and this week, astronomers using ESO's Very Large Telescope and the associated instruments that it has on there have found a really strange exoplanet. The planet is called WASP 76b, and it orbits its star, WASP 76, once every 1.81 days. Now, that's its year, folks. The system is located some 640 light-years away in the area of the sky bounded by the constellation Pisces. WASP 76b itself is what astronomers call a hot Jupiter, meaning that it's about the size of Jupiter, and, you guessed it, it's hot. It's about 1.8 times larger in radius than Jupiter, and it's a little less massive, at about 0.9 times the mass of Jupiter. Now, a really large planet the size of Jupiter going around its star once every couple of days is strange enough, but because its year is so short, that also means it's pretty close to the star, which makes it very hot. And being so close also means that it's grabbed pretty closely by the star itself, and is bound to the star. WASP 76 is an F7 star that is about 1.7 times bigger than our Sun and 1.5 times as massive. And because of all these factors, WASP 76b is tidally locked to the star in its orbit around it. Now, tidally locked means that the rate at which the planet rotates matches its orbit around the star, which makes one side of the planet always facing the star and the other side always facing away. So here we have a planet that's way bigger and about the same mass as Jupiter, going around an F7 star, which are known to, among other things, emit large amounts of UV radiation, and it's going around that star every couple of days, and it has one side always facing the star and the other side always facing away. Well, that's a party where you know weird stuff's gonna happen. Astronomers looking at this system using ESO's VLT, and specifically the spectral imager known as Espresso, which is a fiber optic high-resolution spectrograph, and when they looked at the planet, they did it in various spots in the transit itself, and that's the part where the planet passes between us and the star. And they were able to look at it in such a way that on the day side of the planet, where the temperatures were around 2400K, and that, you know, that's hot. That means that's about the same temperature as some of the smaller stars that are, some of the cooler stars that are out there. So the daytime side is really hot. And looking at those spectral images, they were able to closely follow the neutral iron in the atmosphere as the daytime on the planet progressed, because they were looking at different parts of the planet in its orbit. Now, because different parts of the planet were visible to us as the planet went around, and correcting for all the motions and the planet rotation and orbital motion, the team looked at what was happening to the iron content in the atmosphere. So this is kind of cool. What they noticed was when they could see more of the daytime side disk, that was the, and when it was in the part of the orbit where they could see more of the daytime, they saw more iron. Because we're talking about 2400 degrees Kelvin here, it had to be gaseous. Then, looking at the evening terminator, as it became around, then the iron became less visible, but it was still there. And then the iron content went down on the dark side of the planet and in the morning terminator. They couldn't see any then. So, they concluded that since they could see neutral iron in the daytime side and the evening terminator, but not the nighttime side and the morning terminator, the gaseous iron in the atmosphere must have condensed as it moved into the night side. And since the nighttime temps are still pretty hot, but they're around 1600 degrees K, that's still hot enough for iron to be a liquid. So, it rains. Iron. Molten iron. And here's what they think that would look like. This is iron condensing into rain. Now, this wasn't in the paper, but it makes me wonder about the oceans on WASP 76b. You would need a hell of a boat to sail on molten seas. But then again, maybe it's more like a giant version of the Mustafar system in Star Wars. Now, who knows? We could maybe have just found the birthplace of Darth Vader. I know, I hate that. Don't you hate when people do that? So, enough of that. All right, I want to thank all of Deep Astronomy Patreon patrons who keep these episodes coming, and I want to thank all of you for watching. And as always, keep looking up.